Okay.
Well, it came up immediately.
How's it? Any buffering?
Not yet.
All
Oh,
right.
there it goes.
Is it buffering now?
For a second, but I don't know.
Okay. So I cranked the settings as far down as possible because my internet is just that bad here, I guess. This is, you know what? This is why I haven't been streaming much lately. It's just my internet has been so bad.
It's kind of unreasonable, and I'm sorry.
Whoa. And now Twitch chat is freaking out.
Oh gosh.
Oh. That was weird. Okay, well, let me know if it keeps buffering again or something wonky, but hopefully for now, it's at least smooth enough.
Hopefully,
And we're starting.
I can't tell so much with the frame dropping sometimes unless it's actively buffering because I have to mute it after a few minutes because I can't listen to myself talk.
Pat, no, it's okay.
So, keep us posted, friends.
Yes, please, please, please let me know. Panic. But yeah, yeah, just let me know if it gets bad again. But hopefully we should be good for now, and I started over again. So, what was like the last thing I said before I cut out? I guess I'll read this again. No, my name is Marin. You must still be feeling a little woozy. You're on Koholint Island. Follow the lane south to reach the beach where I found you. Since you washed ashore, lots of nasty monsters have been in the area, so be careful, okay? Okie dokie. Well, both to Marin and you. Hey, what are you doing in my chest? Where'd you learn to do such a thing?
We're a
Well.
protagonist. We've got to loot everything.
Yep. Well, Link, you finally snapped out of it. Name's Taren. Hope you're feeling better. What? How did I know your name? You think it's weird, eh? Well, I saw it on the back of this shield.
I love the idea that Link like just fucking puts labels on the shit that he owns.
I know, right? Just scrawls his name on the back.
Gonna etch my name into the shield here. Whoops, the hilt of the sword that isn't the master sword, because I'm sure he couldn't do that on that. It's just like I'm just gonna write my name here. Expose his name to the back of his tunic, etc., etc. Like a nerd.
Press the button and repel enemies with it. So, shield ourselves. Wow, this looks pretty heavy. You won't be able to lift it with just your bare hands. The annoying thing is, every time you even marginally brush up against these pots, it'll make that, like, text box appear in a new area. It's
God.
kind of annoying. Anyway. Okay, now here we are in Koholint Island, and I will redo my explanation of So basically, in this is the update version called DX, where it's all in color, woo!
Thanks.
Because Game Boy Color came out, and they were like, "Hey, let's make it all color," I guess. And they took out one extremely game-breaking bug in this version that existed in the previous version, which was it had to do with a map transition glitch, basically, Where basically if you hit select as soon as you screen transitioned, it would not send you to the next screen, but the next screen. So you could literally, at the edge of, like, say, the beach or something, you could wrap around the entire island and come back around to the top, right? And then you could just enter the final dungeon through a series of more screen transition glitches. So it's pretty broken. So the any percent of Link's Awakening, at least for the black and white version, is like under 5 minutes. I think that includes all the ending cutscene stuff too, actually. So yeah, that glitch does not exist. They fixed that in this version, but there's still another glitch that exists that lets you kind of break the game somewhat. And I'll show that off later because I do not want to destroy my game right now. Hey man, when you want to save, just push all the buttons at once. Don't ask me what that means. I'm just a kid. Doge. Aw, why you gotta be like that, Doge? Anyway, so we have to find our sword because we can't even cut any grass or anything right now. Ah, yes. The shopkeeper. Hey, welcome. See something you like? Just bring it here. Well, we don't have any money, so... If there's one thing I definitely will not be doing in this playthrough, it's... It's be a thief.
Stealing. Be murder. Yeah.
I won't risk the name of my save file for that.
Nope.
Well, it seems that after you save, you will start at the last door you went through. I'm not really sure why that is, because I'm just a kid.
Kids don't know shit.
Except somehow we do. yes. Yep. Those are my boys. I'm Papal. Pleased to meet ya. I'll be lost in the hills later, so keep a lookout for me here. Spoilers much.
I have no faith in my sense of direction, so watch out for my side quest.
Because they all look alike, even I am sometimes confused. By the way, my baby wants a Yoshi doll. I saw one at the Trendy Game, but I couldn't get it. A Yoshi doll, you say? Here sleeps the flying
Your
rooster.
Your agent has very specific tastes.
Hey, Yoshi's cute.
I know, I'm just saying, like, it's an infant. It doesn't really have object permanence yet. How's it gonna know the difference between a Yoshi doll and any other small stuffed creature?
This is true. Here sleeps the flying rooster. Rip and rip.
Rip. Oh dear, console stream is buffering eternally suddenly.
Oh god. I'm not even dropping that many frames though.
Maybe it's me then.
No, it's buffering on my end too.
Sigh. Like, it doesn't say you've gone offline, so it's just super buffering.
Oh, and Firefox is deciding to crash. it just blarged. Hang on.
Oh, wait. No, it's... Okay, well, it's going on my end now, but it literally came up at the point where I'm saying, well, it sure is buffering eternally, so it's like, wow, that's going to be behind forever now. What is even happening?
Like, I'm not dropping that many frames, and it, even my stream configuration quality is saying excellent. So, I'm infinitely confused.
Sobbing. Something major going on Twitch today? No, no.
Something weird happened. Oh, there you go. How about some fishing, little buddy? It'll only charge you 10 rupees. I'll only charge you 10 rupees. Not now. You have to have more passion. Live a little. Yes, because fishing is the height of living. Bring, bring. Hello, it's me, Ulrilla. I never know how to pronounce this. Like, in Japanese, it's Ururida?
Mm-hmm.
Which is already a weird name. But how do you even pronounce that in English? I don't even know. Anyway, ask me anything about the island. If you get lost, give me a call. Bye, click. Yahoo! I'm fine! And you? Wow, that is a very energetic elderly lady. Also, this is Ulrilla himself.
I'm so far behind, I don't even know.
Oh, how to say? Please call outside. It seems that old man Ururida is a shy guy in person. Ring, 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 click. Yes, it's the Bucket Mouse. Thanks for calling. Well, click. Huh? You must have dialed the wrong number. Link checked the chest. Wow, this is a nice chest. No comment. Yeah, so Ururida is kind of shy in person. Well, he's very talkative on the phone, so. Why am I slowly just dropping more and more frames?
I don't know.
Makeup! Jewels! Dresses! I want it all! And some new accessories would be nice. Okay, tiny, tiny talking chomp. That was the one thing this game fucked me up, is because there are Mario enemies all over the place in this game.
I don't know a whole lot about this game, but, like, yeah, I always, like, that's a weird thing I know about it. But, like, I can't be mad because I really like chain chomps. They're just so weirdly cute.
Well, the chain chomps are fine. It's like when they start throwing Goombas at you is when I go, hey, wait a second, now.
Now hold the phone.
And yeah, they are definitely going to throw freaking Goombas at us. Sorry, just checking anything. Yeah, looks like my internet has suddenly tanked, and I don't know why, and I hate my life, because it was fine, like, not even half an hour ago. Oh well.
Hi.
Yeah. Oh, my Bow Wow is so proud of his fine fur coat! Fur coat? Yip yip! No, seriously. Fur coat?
No.
I think that's it for this area. Okay, so let's head to the beach. We can't go up there yet. I heard that you can press select to look at the island map, but I don't understand what they mean by that. When you're running out of hearts, you'd better enter a house or cave. Why? I have no idea, I'm just a kid. Oh yes, the tutorial house, if you will. This is not a chest. What? You knew that? Okay. Yeah, it's a bookshelf. Why didn't I just say it's a bookshelf, game? Fun with bombs. Read this book? Yes. After you put a bomb down, you can pick it up by pressing the button again. The bomb button. You can then throw it by pushing the button one more time. Did you know that? The properties of warp holes. Read this book? There are some warp holes on Koholint Island. You can warp to and fro using these holes. If you jump into the warp hole at which you arrived, you will go to the next one in the sequence. You can only warp to a hole you have seen with your own eyes. Atlas of Koholint Island. You can move the cursor and look up the name of a place. Do you want to look at this map? Yes. So, right off the bat, they already give you an entire map of the area, which is interesting. Yes. And you can, in fact, look up names of places. Like, here's level 5. You can immediately figure out where everything is. Richard's Villa is over here. But it's only in this sales house o' bananas and other things. We are currently in the village library. But yeah, this is only in the library, and you have to actually explore the place in order for it to be registered on your personal map. Mm-hmm. And this is the windfish's egg. We haven't even heard about this windfish yet.
What a mystery.
Dark Secrets and Mysteries of Koholint. Do you really want to read it? What kind of question is that?
Yeah.
What's this? You can't read the tiny print without the aid of a magnifying glass.
What do you need glasses to?
You do actually have to find a magnifying glass in order to read that book. Selecting the item that's right for you. Read this book? You can select your favorite item for the A and B buttons on the subscreen. Using different items, you can fight without a sword. Try many different things to find what's right for you. Auto Map and Memo Guidebook. Read this book? You can see an island map by pressing the select button. The dark parts of the map are places you have not yet visited. Move the cursor and press the A button to get more information about an area or to replay the message you got there. Ah, how convenient. Says the book itself. Or is that Link saying that? I don't even know.
It's a mystery.
Secrets of the Whirling Blade. Read this book? The whirling blade technique has been handed down from generation to generation by the family of the hero. To use it, hold down the sword button and build up your power. When you have enough, you can release the button. Can you master this?
Passed down to the Armstrong
family for generations. Sparkles. How to handle your shield. Like a pro. Read this book. If you hold the button down, you can defend yourself from enemy attacks, and you can flip some enemies too. Besides a standard shield, there is also a mirrored variety, which can defend against beams. And also, there's a book up here, but we cannot reach it yet. Okay, Tail Cave to the right, and Torombo Shores down here. There are enemies and we'll get punched, so let's just go this way.
You don't get punched.
Beware of sea urchins. Don't touch them with your bare hands. So we can just kind of shove them around with our shield here. Eh. Like, okay, so A, how big are these sea urchins actually? And B, can you imagine... can you imagine Link just shoving a giant sea urchin around with his shield?
Yes.
Ah, and here's our sword. Hi. Hoo-hoo! So, you are the lad who owns the sword. Now I understand why the monsters are starting to act so violently. A courageous lad has come to wake the windfish. It is said that you cannot leave the island unless you wake the windfish. You should now go north, to the mysterious forest. I will wait for you there. Woo! You found your sword. It must be yours, because it has your name engraved on it. And now the real music starts up. Oh, I need to switch which buttons those are on. Okay, thank you. Okay, now we're really playing. So yeah, there's not too much we can go around to quite yet. Because we can't pick things up. We can't pick up heavy rocks. We can't even pick up mildly heavy pots. There's this guy here. Welcome to Sail's House of Bananas. I'm Sail. This is my house. Actually, my hobby is collecting rare and unusual canned food. My brother is an artist, so I guess strange hobbies run in the family. I like how his bed is just in, like, a lake or, like, a tiny pond thing. Sorry.
No, it's not your fault. Oh, there it is. Yeah, I want like a weird lake bed. That's awesome.
Oh, yes, one of these things. You've got a guardian acorn. It will reduce the damage you take by half. For like a couple screens. And it gives you this interesting music, which kinda gets annoying after a little while, to be honest.
Oh dear.
I mean, it's not the worst. It's just that it's such a short loop. Goodbye. Oh yes, this is actually the first dungeon, but we don't have the key yet. Hung? A keyhole here? It says tail keyhole. Now we get the usual. I wasn't talking to you. I wanted to pick up this bush. Now we have the usual Mabe Village music. We can also fall into this hole. And there's a heart piece. You've got a piece of heart. Press select on the subscreen to see. Oh yes, this cave music. They reuse this for the Oracle games. I'm so used to it. Right, obviously this game was before the Oracle games, and why can't I get on these stairs? Okay. So it carries over, like the Oracle games carried over a lot. I mean, obviously the graphics, but also a lot of some of the music and a lot of the mechanics. And it is also by Capcom, so make that of that what you will. If I had more monies, I would try to get the Yoshi doll, but... Actually, the Ururida, phone booth house music is a little spoopy. Just a smidge. How much was it to do the thing? Trendy game! One play, 10 Rs. Alright, I need 10 rupees. I might come back to it. I do want the magic powder in there too, though. Maybe I'll just cut all this grass. Oh, right! You found a secret seashell. If you collect a lot of these, something good is bound to happen. Okay. So these motherfucking shells are hard to find. And it is extremely easy to, screw yourself over and miss, a couple of them.
Of course. I think I remember you talking about these.
Yeah, I was probably extremely pissed at the time. See if Marin has anything to say. Oh, they're both gone. Oh, Marin must be out here. Up here. Yep, there she is. Hi, Taryn went to the forest to look for toadstools, but I'd rather sing. Listen to this. It's called the Ballad of the Windfish. And I'll leave it for a second because I really like the song. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's kind of the main theme of the game, and it's really pretty. Mm-hmm. And that's basically all Marin's really going to be doing all game, is standing around singing, so...
She's so cute.
She is cute. Okay, you're still not lost yet. Fine.
It's a prototype of my fave.
Yep. She is Malin Beta. Malon Beta. Gah! No, I didn't want to do that. Gosh darn it.
Oh no.
Puppy!
Oh no, what did you do?
It happens. I'm cutting grass, and then they get in the way of my sword, and I'm like, oh no, I didn't mean to do the thing.
Oh no.
Welcome back.
Welcome back.
Alright, let's actually do this. The A and B buttons move the crane. The rest is just timing. Go over to the buttons to play. Good luck. Alright, let me see. Let me see if I can time this correctly. Let me just go get the Yoshi doll first. That one's obviously the easiest. Oh, I think I went a little too far. Maybe? Oh, I was a little too far over. Alright, we'll get more rupees and come back.
Here.
But yeah, the hidden shells actually give you the best sword in the game.
Of course.
If I remember correctly. So it's worth it, but it's also frustrating if you're not following a guide. Actually, did I want... I want the shovel, but it's like 200 rupees, so yeah. There's not much over this way, too, if I remember. I'm just stalling before I go the right way, quote-unquote. East, Ukuku Prairie. Farther east, Animal Village. Yes, there is a village that is nothing but sentient animals.
Good.
I mentioned this when the stream went down, but I'm not risking the name of my save file just to grab an item. Mm-hmm. I would rather not be called thief for the rest of the game.
Constant reminder of your sins.
Sins. Ancient sins. Ancient sins.
Ancient sins.
Anyway, mysterious forest, Wiggle Fingers. It's a little bit mysterious. Whoo! Ho, brave lad, on your quest to wake the dreamer. Welcome to the mysterious wood. Much of the mystery you will find on this uncharted Koholint Island. I'm afraid you may find it a trifle difficult to leave the island while the windfish naps. By the by, have you ever visited the Tail Cave, which is south of the village? Go there with the key you find in this forest. The windfish is watching. Whoo! I know, the bow is highway robbery, but yeah. Anyway, mysterious forest. That's just a tiny bit mysterious. Okay, this triangle thing is kind of like the acorn, and I'll only grab it once here because it has the same kind of slightly annoying music, but it basically boosts your power. You got a piece of power! You can feel the energy flowing through you! And it makes enemies fly! Beware of floors with cracks! A heavy person should not stand on them. Rude. But Link is always just a little on the heavy side because of all the shit he carries.
Chen would never survive caves like this.
Pat, except... but she can fly!
It's true. Okay, in a hypothetical situation where she can't use the magic.
Oh. I swear there's a fairy there sometimes, or am I misremembering? Maybe it's the wrong spot.
I'm sorry, the stream just got to the part where that slime just decided life is not worth anything.
Goodbye, cruel world.
Like, you went right for that fucking coal in the ground. Like, good lord. Please, slime, life is worth more than this.
Oh, that still electrocutes me. Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I'm just trying to transition so I can get rid of this music.
Why would you make your long-term power-up craft like a fucking very short loop? That's terrible.
It is a little bad. Okay, there we go. Just enter the cave. There we go. Because I like the music in the woods. Oh! Right. As a raccoon, my nose is very sensitive to stuff like dust and powder. You're going to be lost thanks to me. Yep, he won't let you move any further. Oh, there's the fairy. Why did she show up? Let's heal your wounds and get rid of all that stress. Close your eyes and relax. Maybe she only shows up when I'm injured. It's always a little interesting, I very much appreciate the touch, but you can tell Link is left-handed here from any angle. And all the other monsters are right-handed, so you actually, like, it's this kind of interesting clash of swords because the swords are on opposite sides. Like, I don't know how to explain, but I enjoy it. So anyway, yeah, that guy won't let us through because he's a jerk. So, we need the magic powder from the crane game, actually, in actuality.
Whoops.
But, I need some more money first. So, we're going to traverse through this cave and grab this. You got 50 rupees! Very nice!
With the money.
With the money!
Things from the shop.
Can I not? Oh, wow, this looks pretty heavy. I can't pick up a freaking skull. Like, just how big are these skulls, for crying out loud? Where'd I come out to? Oh, yes, the mushroom. I need this. You pick the toadstool. As you hold it over your head, a mellow aroma flows into your nostrils. I believe this is the starting item for your long quest chain, if I remember correctly. Because there is a quest chain, as usual, in this game.
There is.
Yeah, I can't cross over this way. Nope, don't need it. Gosh darn it, what did I just say? I know it's kind of beneficial, but it's just slightly annoying. Because every time you pick it up, it pauses and gives you that text, and then it's like the loop of the music, so it's just like a... Yeah, well, I have enough money now, so I can go do the thing. But it will poke over here really quick. Let's see. Crazy Tracy and Mambo's Pond. It's a spooky grave!
What?
Ah, yes. Also, I believe Syrup, the witch? I believe her name was Syrup.
That's
adorable. Double, double, toil and trouble, a toadstool mix makes powder for tricks! Oh, right. I guess she could make it too, with this. Here, I have a toadstool. Yunk. Ah, it has the sleepy toadstool, it does. We'll mix it up something in a jiffy, we will. Mix! It's all ready, it is. Take care, as there's not much there. Why not try a bit in my hut? You've got some magic powder. Try sprinkling it on a variety of things. So the magic powder's interesting. It can light torches.
Mm-hmm.
Good job! Use it on your enemies and see what happens! If you run out, go to the forest, pick some mushrooms, and I will make you more. She's very kind.
What a helpful witch friend.
So... was it... I still can't remember if her name was Maple or if it was Syrup. Anyway, I believe her name is Syrup. And she shows up in... the Oracle games as well, but then she has an apprentice called Maple, who flies around and is a jerk. I mean, she's cute.
She's so cute.
I know. Kate, hey, can I sprinkle you? Nope. Nothing on the mouse.
Why would you want to set mouse friend on fire?
Well, it has different properties depending on the thing. For example, if I'm to if I sprinkle it on this jerk. This happens. And then I can kill him, I think. Oh! Hey, Mon? Wait, I can talk to him? What? Oh god, I'm dying, okay. I can talk to him? What was that? That's something that's never happened before. Oh, and then I fucking... wow. How's the stream, by the way?
I don't know, like, again, since I have it muted, I can't tell all the time, and it has buffered a few times, but as it's, like, straight up buffered for 1,000 years for a while, so...
Okay. For some reason, it's frozen on one spot in my preview window for some reason.
Oh dear.
Anyway. What happens if I were to sprinkle a moblin? I set him on fire.
Whoops.
Alright, well, we can use this powder to, get rid of the tanuki who's being a jerk.
You gotta be like that to make your friend. Not friend, technically.
Hey! Yeet! Whoops! He was actually Terran. The last thing I can remember was biting into a big juicy toadstool. Then I had the darndest dream. I was a raccoon. Yep, sounds strange, but it sure was fun.
Wow.
I'm all tuckered out. I think I better set a spell before I head home.
Just imagining biting into a raw-ass mushroom. Woof.
Yeah, why would you do that?
Like, straight out of the dirt, too. Just woof.
Why would you do this?
Why would you ever?
You've got the tail key. Now you can open the tail cave gate. Wait a minute. You guys spelled it tail as in your tail on your butt, but earlier it was spelled tail as in story? Sorry, you were saying.
No, just like I was just, you know, I love me some mushrooms, but I'm not wrong.
Whew! Take the key and go to the tail cave. Retrieve the instrument that is hidden there. Go now. The windfish is waiting. Whew! There is this mysterious windfish that he keeps talking about.
What a mystery.
And also go up here, Gapongo Swamp, Mysterious Forest. But there's a like. But there's not much up here. Yet. Bring, bring! Udidia speaking! You know, there is a library in the village that might have some good information for you. Talk to you later, click. Yeah, I can't do much about the swamp yet. Danger, keep out! Except Bow Wow. Cough. Wink, wink.
Wink, wink.
Oh, sorry. I don't know why I keep reading signs that I've already read. Anyway. Let me try grabbing that Yoshi again. I hope that's close enough. Yes! You got a Yoshi doll! Recently, he seems to be showing up in many games. Okay, I swore the toadstool was part of the thing, but... was it the Yoshi doll instead? I don't know, my memory's going. The Yoshi doll might be the start of this chain. We'll see. Ah, look what I got! Oh, will you give that doll to my baby? Here you go. Oh, thank you. You are indeed a generous person. Oh, I will give you this in return. Yep, here we go.
Ah, questions.
You traded your Yoshi for a bow. Maybe you can trade the ribbon for something else. Now let's see, who's looking for maybe a cute accessory? Makeup, jewels, dresses, I want it all! And some new accessories would be nice. Oh, that ribbon! I need it! Will you trade it for my dog food? Sure. Lucky! Delicious. Thanks! Well, here's your can! You exchange the ribbon for a can. It's full of juicy beef. Look, somehow this is freaking adorable. Look at this. Alright. Trying to remember. Oh, right. So there was somebody who was interested in rare canned goods.
Yes. So, oh no, the chain chomp with the bow is super cute. What the hell?
It is actually fairly cute.
Illegal.
Hello there. What's that you have? It's canned food. For heaven's sake, man, give that can to me, please. He's hysterical. What do you do? Give. Oh, thank you. I'll take that. Wow, chomp.
Jesus.
That was great. I know it's not a fair trade, but here's some bananas. Yum. You gave him the can and got bananas in return. Good deal. Thank you again. That was yummy. Alright, so we can see in our menu that we've got the bananas. I don't think we can reach the person who wants the bananas quite yet, so... let's just go to Tail Cave. Yoink! Welcome to our first dungeon, level 1 Tail Cave. It's Poopy. Ah, these assholes. So yeah, there's also a lot of enemies that they carried over to the Oracle games as well, so... Jerk McPushy Faces are here. You've got the compass. Now you can see where the chests and nightmare are hidden. This compass has a new feature. A tone will tell you if a key is hidden in a room when you enter. Which is super helpful, actually.
Yes. Everything.
Oh, right, here we go. The actual dungeon map is in your status screen. It's weird. Also, oh yeah, you can hold select and you can see how many heart pieces you have and what tunic you're currently wearing, as well as how many pictures you've gotten so far. Oh yes, that's the tone. Very tiny tone. Actually, now that I think about it, they don't explain that tone at all in the Oracle games. Maybe they just figured you should already remember it from this game? I don't know.
That or just kind of like, you know, one by two.
Yeah, I feel like they like dialed back the tutorializing a bit in the Oracle games and made it just generally flow a little better compared to Link's Awakening. There's just a lot of fucking text boxes that were like mildly annoying. You got 20 rupees. Joy! Oh god, these guys. Hey. Hey, you. I haven't found the map yet, so I can't. Ow. Wow, jerks, that actually really hurt. Wanna give me a heart? No? I'm just gonna be jerks? Okay. Oh yes, the owls. They're these little owl-like statue things. If you can find the beak in a dungeon, then it'll give you like hints, basically. This owl statue is trying to say something, but you can't understand it because it has no beak.
So sad.
And it must scream. God. Sorry, that was grim.
That was real grim. I laughed because I'm a bad people, so.
Oh, hi, Goombas!
Fucking why?
Fancy seeing you here.
Why?
You can smush him. Oh, except I'm bad at it. Well, that was easy enough. You've got the rock's feather. It feels like your body is a lot lighter. So our first item is actually jump.
Nice.
Ow. I got a piece of power again. Whatever. Just instantly explode skeletons. At last, you got a map! Press the start button to look at it. There we go. I'm missing a spot. These doors that are like in the shape of a person are one-way doors, basically. They'll rotate you to the other room, and then you can't get back.
Yeah.